Well, hi there. I'm Matt Adams with Loupe. Now, if you've been following my series on Git, you may have started to think that using some of the collaboration tools like branching and merging could get a little bit unwieldy if you're not careful, and you'd be completely right. So what I want to walk through today is how we handle that here at Loupe by using Gitflow. So what is Gitflow? Gitflow is a branching model for Git that was created by Vincent Dreisen back in 2010. And what it does is it allows parallel development by separating development work from code that's released. And it does this using three concepts: permanent branches, support branches, and tags. So let's go ahead and just start with the permanent branches, main and develop. The main branch holds released versions. And at Loupe, these are the ones that reside on machines running in the field. Now, the developed branch contains the latest completed development features or non-critical bug fixes that will be implemented in the next main release. And these permanent branches are both supported by temporary branches called feature, release, and hotfix. And these are created, merged into a permanent branch, and then actually deleted. And what I want to do next is walk through using these branches with Gitflow, step by step, by using three really common scenarios. For our first scenario, you're at a point where you want to make a new feature. And the first step is going to be creating a feature branch from develop. Now at Loupe, we always recommend naming a branch in the format of branch type slash name. So let's say you had to add a stacklight to your machine. In this case, you might create a branch called feature slash stacklight. You'll then work along on the feature until it's complete, and then you're going to merge it back into the develop branch. Now, in my previous video, I walked through merging, but Gitflow has an important best practice that I want to make sure I mention. You always want to merge by creating a new commit, even if you could fast forward. And this is also known as the no fast forward or the no FF flag, which is usually just a checkbox in most Git clients, but you want to make sure that you check into your individual client to see. No fast forward ensures that you only have one commit per feature. Now, if you have fast forward allowed, what you can do is end up having a feature merge that would add all of the commits into the feature branch like this. And this can make it hard to know which commits actually complete a feature. Now, our second scenario is actually machine commissioning, because at some point you're going to need to get code on a machine. And commissioning or updating is always done on the release branch. On this branch, we're focusing on getting the machine ready to ship, so we're not going to be adding any features. We're fixing bugs or correcting physical discrepancies, like maybe I/O mapping or reversing some motor directions. And now once this is done, what we're going to do is we're going to merge the supporting release branch into the permanent main branch. And once it's merged in, that's where the tagging comes in. What we're going to do is tag it with a version number. In this case, it's version 1.3. Now, importantly, this version number is tied to a variable that's visible on the machine HMI, and this solves the age-old question of, hey, does anybody remember what version is running on that machine from 5 years ago? And now here's something else that's really important. You want all future development work to have these same corrections that you made during that release process. So what you're going to do is merge the release branch back into the develop branch, so you're not making the same field corrections over and over. Now, the third scenario is an accepted pragmatic evil: hotfixes. If you've ever worked in the real world, you know that things get missed, and sometimes they aren't discovered until a machine is actually running in the field. In this case, you can do what's known as a hotfix. You'll branch off the main into a hotfix branch, make the correction, and then merge it back into main. Of course, you'll need to create a new version number, and at Loupe, all of our hotfixes are adjusted in that third decimal place, which is why this is version 1.3.1. And finally, just like the commissioning changes from release were merged into main and develop, we need to merge the hotfix changes into the develop branch too, so we're not hotfixing future versions. And once you're done with this, you can continue on and on doing the same thing: developing features, releasing them for test, and then shipping them out with machines. Oh, and one other thing. All of these support branches, those changes are implemented now, so you can just go ahead and delete them. This leaves a clean set of releases on the main branch and a clear place to continue development right on the develop branch. And this is what makes Gitflow an excellent workflow choice for using Git with PLCs.